family of lots, 1-800 Call Sam. Fastball strike to Lorenzo Cain. He grounded out to third his first time up. Soft contact so far off these Royals bats. Soler hit the ball decently in his at bat in the third, a fly ball to center. Other than that, nothing has been hit hard, and that's what we've been watching all year, of course, with Michael Fulmer. Slider in the dirt, 1-1 on Cain. Soft little pop up in the shallow right center. JD will drift in and make the easy grab for out number three.
Another defensive swing.
Michael Fulmer's faced the minimum 12 batters through four. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth inning in Detroit. 4-0 Tigers over the Royals. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
Maybe you're asking yourself, who is that guy in the mirror in the crew cut this position? What happened to the guy with the brass knuckle attitude? Maybe he just needs to decide.
Seventh inning. Corey Kluber pitching. had chances on that pitch away. He flipped his bat on it.
He's smart doing that. Borderline pitches.
Today's game box in part by Parkway Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Just show up, sign up, and ride. 4-0 Tigers in the bottom of the fourth. Torres at second, shades up the middle, straight up on the left side for Escobar and Moustakas, the 3-2. The pop fly to right field, Bonifacio comes a little more, makes the easy grab. 8-pitch battle, won in the end by Junis. 1-1 down here in the fourth.
We want to pass along a great hello to Mark Thorne, a big Tiger fan. Taylor, my whole family listens to the ball games, and Mark wrote a wonderful note. And they're from Harrison Township. They also put nice there next to where they're from. So we just appreciate these wonderful letters about enjoy the games and all the you and I bantering back and forth and so forth. But Mark Coleman and the whole family from Harrison Township, nice area.
And didn't you also get somebody who sent in some lyrics?
And thought it in the lip. Yeah, wrote a song for me.
There's a pitch away, and if you're going to mention that, I just wanted to mention that. If you mentioned the name, I just want to make sure people do not get encouraged by this.
Yeah, you know, the funny thing about it, the stamp is Elvis Presley on the stamp. What does that tell you?
Mikey Matuk takes a pitch off the plate inside.
Yeah, Glenn Jones from Grand Rapids wrote a beautiful, beautiful Swinging at the Motion song. Dan really likes it a lot.
Because my partner will say that sounds like a song on just about anything.
Yes.
And one night he said, Swinging at the Motion sounds like a song, so...
I got a song.
Here's a soft chopper over the mound, charging Escobar, gloves, throws on the grass, and not in time. Speed of Mikey Matuk, he legs out an infield hit. That was creative. But we just don't want to encourage listeners to think, every time my partner said it sounds like a song.
But you know, like Glenn Jones put his heart into it, like the Coleman family, we really appreciated it.
Yes.
But someday, in a rain delay, but we'll sing this together, Dan.
You have to now come up with a tune.
I saw arms and elbows, fingers and toes. That's just part of it. And see, you know what, by the way, he's from a nice area also, Grand Rapids.
Very nice. It's a high fly ball, right field, 40 deep. Bonifacio back, looking up, and it's gone. Andrew Romine with number 3, and you got to hit it hard to get it out to right field today. 6-0 Tigers.
But Dan, you know, we lost the right field to go back to the wall, thinking you can catch it. That ball went about 10 rows up and went into the stands there. That's a big one. We'll run the party pop for the original party pop for over 100 years, and that's a double boogie whip by Andrew Romine, batting ninth, and he hits a home run. Yeah, that ball was way out of here.
I was not sure it'd be possible to get a ball out to right today. That was so high, I kept waiting for it to be knocked down, but like you said, Bonifacio went back and realized, nope,
no chance.
Third home run of the day for the Tigers in a 6-0 lead here in the fourth. Ian Kinsler takes a strike. On the inside corner, backup slider on the inner half, 2-for-2 for Kinsler today. He too has put up some very solid numbers since coming off the disabled as the home run power has kicked in the last couple of weeks. He had 3 home runs on the road trip. Curveball backs up inner half of the plate and misses, 1-1. So now 9 home runs for Ian Kinsler, showing he's still got that 20 home run power. It was a very quiet start in the power department. There's a pitch in the dirt. I don't think there's any question the hamstring had something to do with it.
Oh, absolutely. Tried to play through it, didn't work.
10 days on the DL, got the hamstring right.
Right.
And it's been impressive power since he's returned. Here's the 2-1. Lane away, 3-1 on Kinsler. Nobody yet throwing in that Kansas City bullpen.
I think it's his for a while, don't you think?
I think that's what Ned Yost is letting him know.
That's right.
You know what, we really could use a couple more innings out of you. Kansas City's going home to face the Minnesota Twins. 3-1, swinging a foul out of play, and it's always good news when you're going home, but maybe not good news going home to face the Minnesota Twins.
Because they're great on the road, which makes no sense at all.
16-25 at home, 24-11.
That's crazy.
On the road, as good as almost any team in baseball, not named the Houston Astros. Ian swings and taps it foul right at home plate, stays alive. Astros are 29-9. There are only a handful of teams out of the 30 major league teams that have even a winning record on the road, much less a really good record on the road. But it's the Astros, and then it's the Minnesota Twins.
That is
we'll figure.
We said that before the year started. I said you were crazy.
The second best road record, and really everybody else lags far behind. Washington and Cleveland are both right around 25-15, 24-15.
They always play 50 even on the road,
right? The 3-2 again. Swinging a ground ball to third. Moustakas near the line, gloves it off the dirt across the diamond to Hosmer for the second out here in the fourth inning. 6-0, Tigers on top.
The Tigers leading Friday's party pack available for all Friday home games. Friday's coming up. Includes a game ticket, vouch for 20-ounce beer starting as low as $19. Visit Tigers.com to find out more about tickets.
Tigers will take a road trip to Kansas City and Minnesota right after the All-Star break. That's the next time the Tigers see the Twins. I'm amazed at what the Twins are doing. They appear to be short in the pitching department, but
on the road, no.
Everything clicks on the road. They just got into Boston and taken two straight.
Yeah, that's right. Did they win last night?
They did.
That's something.
Jeez. But they lost, I guess, game one, didn't they, to Sale?
Yeah.
And then they won last night. Alberto Mejia in the bullpen.
Jeez.
A 4-1 win. The strike one to Alex. Strike two. Off speeding on the outside corner. He got frozen by a changeup his last time in a 2-2 count. Walked and rode home on the Upton home run in the first. Kinsler with a solo home run in the third. Now after the infield base hit from Matuk Romine with a home run deep to right field. A high target from Perez. Fastball up and in. Alex will still strike out, but he certainly seems to have laid off that pitch better, Jim, and closed that hole, if you will, the fastball up to Sweet instead of
left. Absolutely correct. I would agree with that. Absolutely.
Works toward the third base side, into his motion, the 1-2. Way inside has Alex jumping back and falling across home plate.
Number 65, this young kid, they're hurting with starting pitching.
Thank you.
The crack of the bat's still in my ear. It really is. He hurts the ball.
Jacob Junis making his sixth start of the year. Delivers a fastball that's fouled out of play. Hellebach first base side. Junis, nothing that really jumps out at you in the minor leagues, just consistency through the minor leagues. And he's 24, Jim. I think he's still got a shot at former 29th round pick, so he's certainly better the odds to get to the major leagues. But it was low walks, good strikeout rate. ERAs went up and down, but you look at the walks and strikeouts, he's a good guy. He's just swinging a tap foul. But you would think, Jim, that's going to be very important for him at the major league level to be precise with his strike throwing, because he has not been at the major league level, and that's constant.
Well, he's got to be, but with his arsenal, I mean, the fastball is an average fastball. So what you really have to do is work on a two-seamer that has some movement on it. If you have to get it on the four-seamer, that's great. But if you're a low 90s fastball, that's your number one pitch. Hey, that's a tough one.
Yeah.
Your other pitches, you don't use them enough. Well, that's what happened today. All of these home runs were hit off fastballs.
Up to hit that off his foot. He has sparked that one off a little bit. Now waiting on the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Slider got him. Late break. Strikeout number four for Junis.
Double play for Lopez Tigers. Another donation. Tax Base for Autism brought to you by Buick, GMC, and Taylor. Nice area. You can always get the best price for you. No question.
Take a little bit of punishment today.
Absolutely.
And I think Ned's pretty savvy about when he needs to let a guy who struggled maybe against the lefties.
Right.
Struggled out against the lefties to third.
What we did to Bruce Scott, he was punishing them.
Yep. It was a swing and a miss. But he figured he had to learn how to do it. So, I mean, this might be one of those days where he's like, okay, you got to see if you can get us through five or six on a day when we don't have our best stuff and we've been hit hard at times.
The learning process, boy, up here, it's tough to learn up here. This is a tough game.
For strike one, Miguel hits ground ball up the middle to his left. Escobar has it to the left to second base, and he's a toss over to Hosmer at first for the second out. That's the thing, you know, you always try to remind yourself with a guy like Daniel Norris. Michael Fulmer is the exception rather than the rule. Yeah, that's 24-year-old Junis. Daniel Norris is 24. It doesn't usually click right away at 24. It is a process.
It is tough.
Alex Avila talked about that after the game because it is frustrating. Heck, it's frustrating for Daniel.
No question.
That he's not more consistent, but it's a process to get to where you want to be.
Right.
J.D. Martinez checks his swing strike on the outside corner.
Well, it's almost like they have to hone him down and kind of rebuild him, up again because the arm is so good. You've really got it all together. It's more consistent.
Alex talks to him all the time. Just take in the moment.
Yeah.
Enjoy where you are and then just focus on that next pitch to handle the strike one. Swinging a soft ground ball at the end of the bat to first, and I mean soft. Hosmer will field to make the play on his system. Today's game brought to you by Airlines Park and the official parking provider of the Detroit Tigers Radio Network. Before you fly, park nearby. 1-2-3 fifth inning for Junis. We head to the sixth in Detroit. 6-0 Tigers over the Royals on the Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
When someone speaks from the heart, we listen carefully. But what about when your heart speaks to you? Take a deep breath. What do you feel? Shortness of breath? Unusual heartbeat? Chest pain? Your heart may be telling you that you're at risk for a pulmonary embolus, a blood clot. It blocks essential oxygen going to your lungs. It's serious. Listen carefully. You need to see a cardiovascular specialist at the Detroit Medical Center. The DMC cardiovascular team has perfected a minimally invasive clot buster procedure that takes special medication to the clot, dissolves it, and returns the flow of oxygen to your heart. An advancement we now teach around the country. So don't wait. Listen to your heart. Find your heart expert at 888-DMC-2500 or dmc.org/heart. DMC, 8 hospitals, 1 commitment to leading heart care.
We have batteries engraved in the bottom of the wall.
Master conventional all-weather motor oil. You'll find 5-quart jugs for just $12.99. Give that ride a showroom look with quality products from Mothers starting at only $5.49. Save on Permatex rust treatment, just $8.99. And find us online at myautovaluestore.com. That's Moto Value, where service is. get it.
40 million Americans wake up to a Gillette shave, and Gillette is working to bring you America's number one shave at lower prices. Go to GilletteOnDemand.com and get your fourth order free.
Start one of the two games on Saturday, and Carrasco will start one of the two games for the Indians. We do know that Matthew Boyd will start